Jesus, you who are reading or listening to this message are not doing so by chance.
May 2nd, 2016, by John Smallman.
Jesus.
Human consciousness is an ongoing spiritual evolutionary process that you collectively chose to undergo, and to which there are no limits. Limits are boundaries that you built around the illusory environment that you inhabit as human beings, but which you are free, individually, to dismantle or move beyond. More and more of you are realizing this and choosing to move through them to an awareness of the limitless possibilities that creation offers you in every moment. Those who do come to an awareness that in truth you are completely free. As more of you open to this wondrous truth and acknowledge it, you enlarge the gaps in the field of limitations from small individual pathways to an immense and interconnected highway that all of humanity can and will use to depart the illusion. Passing out of the limiting environment in which you have spent eons seemingly controlled and restricted by unseen forces of enormous power, you awaken into an infinite field of unimaginably unlimited possibilities. This is what humanity is in the process of doing right now. The worldwide chaos and confusion that is presently arising is identified by humanity as an endless and enormous theater of operations in which global warming, tectonic plate shifts, extreme weather systems, interminable wars, unconscionable corporate and political corruption and greed are seemingly leading to an inevitable global catastrophe that will destroy the environment, and most if not all of the life forms present on Earth, including, of course, humanity. The problems humanity is facing appear almost insoluble. This is not the case. What is happening is the removal of the blinders that hid from you the awareness of the interconnectedness of everything. As you start to see the interconnectedness of absolutely everything, you cannot help also seeing the insanity of the way in which you have been attempting to live your lives separated from one another. Modern psychology has shown you that most people live ego-driven, that is fear-driven, lives in which each one appears to be the center of his own tiny universe, a universe on which the universes of others impinge, causing pain and suffering for all. And much of that suffering is in fact the result of denied feelings that give rise to powerful emotions that are then projected onto others, from whom they are reflected back whence they came, onto oneself. Awakening is an opening to the awareness that all those seeming individual universes that humans appear to inhabit, is in fact one fully integrated part of the infinite field of divine love, which is all that is. A sensed or known awareness that there is no separation, that all are indeed one. God is the infinite field in which all of creation has its eternal existence in perfect harmonious cooperation, where each and every one lovingly honors and respects every other. There are no divisions, disagreements, or conflicts because all recognize one another as one and the same, even though individuated and expressing themselves in an entirely personal and unique fashion. The differences are embraced with intense joy because they add magnificently to the ongoing creative intent, God's divine will. As you have been told so often, there is only God. Within the illusion you are limited by words and language, and so you have many words for God. I use the word God here because it is familiar and comfortable for the channel who grew up in a religious and cultural environment that used, and still uses that word. You have to remember that words are but pointers with no intrinsic meaning, they are convenient indicators but unreal. I will continue to use that word purely for convenience, along with Source, Love, Divine Will, and the pronouns him and her, interchangeably. To continue, there is only God. That is not a limit. It means that all that exists exists within God, and God is infinite, without limits, without boundaries, without end, without time, without space, all of which are limits. As some of your sages and mystics have suggested, God is. No other attempt at definition is necessary, or indeed meaningful. God can only be experienced. To experience God, infinite bliss, all that is not in perfect alignment with her has to be discarded, abandoned, dissolved, released. Humanity is presently in the process of doing that, and it can be very messy. All attachments to unloving intentions, thoughts, words, or actions have to be let go. All judgments of self or others have to be let go. Your hearts are the physical manifestations of your oneness with the divine, the physical aspects representing the center of your eternal being, and into them you have loaded over the eons, fear, hatred, anger, resentment, shame, judgment, bitterness, and worthlessness, among others, as aspects of yourselves that you have then disowned and projected onto others, because they are far too painful to take within yourselves. But, they are within yourselves because all are one. However, the self in which they reside is the ego. The ego is an apparently split off or separate part of yourself. Yourself is eternally one with God, and with all sentient beings, and can never be separated from her. To separate would be to cease to exist, and that is impossible because what God creates is eternal. Your egos are the small selves that you imagined into being to enable you to play the game that is the illusion. Modern psychology uses the term the inner child to refer to the part or aspect of a human that hides behind the mask that a person presents to the world. It hides because during its childhood it was severely hurt and it does not wish to be hurt again. However, it continues to be hurt because it feels vulnerable and insecure, having never grown to maturity, to real adulthood. Its scholastic, academic, and physical talents and skills allow it to present a mask of confidence to the world, but behind that mask a small and frightened child still resides. Psychotherapy in many forms is used to help that inner child gain confidence and self-acceptance by enabling it to see that all its negative self-judgments are utterly invalid. The effectiveness of the efforts of competent and compassionate psychotherapists depends on the suffering the child has had to endure. However, every human is offered, through life lessons of many kinds, the opportunities necessary to heal the inner child, and each of you has at least one spiritual guide who accompanies you at all times to assist you with this demanding process. Over the eons there have been many lives, many experiences, much pain and suffering that has not been healed, and so in this period of humanity's evolution, which is always ongoing and always spiritual, many have volunteered to incarnate solely in order to assist humanity in the release of this enormous residue of buried, denied, or unacknowledged suffering. It is most certainly far too painful for just one human to deal with. Enormous sharing of suffering is occurring, allowing it to be released in amounts that individuals can deal with when they are supported both in the physical realms by loving friends and wise and compassionate therapists, as well as by those of us in the spiritual realms who are also nudging you toward self-acceptance and self-forgiveness. Very many of you have buried or denied pain, pain you feel at some level you either deserve, or that being mature adults, you should be strong enough to rise above. But on this painful and horrifying battleground, which is intensely real and physical for some, from which you are picking yourselves up, you need enormous amounts of help. You cannot arise from it alone. Attempting to do so is to remain in the unreal state of separation from which there seems to be no means of escape. Often intense shame deters people from seeking help, shame disguised as anger, which is then projected outwards causing further damage. It is from states like this that the decision to take one's own life is frequently made. But when that happens it does not resolve the issues from which the person is fleeing. You who are reading or listening to this message are not doing so by chance, coincidence, or accident, but because you made the most compassionate and loving choice to be on earth at this moment to assist in humanity's awakening process, a process that includes and involves every sentient being who has ever experienced life on earth. You are here to help the multitudes who still remain utterly unaware that they are spiritual beings having a temporary human experience. As you have been so often told, each one of you, being in truth one with Source, are beings of enormous power, infinite power, because that is how you were created. That power is with you in every moment and for all eternity. Your physical forms are temporary vehicles composed from your energy fields of love, and your earthly task is to hold the intent to be loving in every moment and in every situation. That intent is extremely powerful and it is an irreplaceable and essential aspect of humanity's awakening process. You cannot awake alone. Why? Because all are one. You could perhaps imagine yourselves as forming the channel that is guiding the separated energy fields of humanity back to oneness with Source. Separation has never occurred, and could never occur, but because of the power you were given when God so lovingly created you, you were able to establish a very real seeming physical environment in which to play your games, and eventually become frighteningly lost. Know that you are most highly honored here in the spiritual realms, to which he will shortly return, for making the most wondrous and compassionate choice to incarnate at this moment in Earth's history to assist in this mighty heavenly project whose success is divinely assured. Your loving brother, Jesus.